I'm going to go to the hospital. Thank you, good evening, and welcome, a very special welcome to those who are joining us by live stream tonight. My name is Rod Ackman, and the group seated on stage are the Sooner Bassooners celebrating our 40th anniversary. I'd like to call to the stage our good friend and very gifted composer, the first work you just heard, Zachary C. Daniels, to say a few words about his piece. Zach.
Thank you so much, Professor Ackman. Professor Ackman has been such a great friend over these years and allowing me to write so much fun bassoon music. And can we get a quick hand for how great these guys are? How great are they? What you just heard was my second bassoon ensemble piece, and I've written a lot of intermittent bassoon works in between, but this one was far different than the first one. The first one, for one, Professor Ackman only has to do this, and that's probably a vacation at this point, right? And you may have noticed that he's sitting there kind of like taking lots of bounces. It's because this piece took a lot of complex meters, and it made the counting really fun, right? Yeah, okay, oh man, see this guy, he knows, he's sitting there like panicking. It's okay, that's what aural skills is for. That's fine, we'll get you. All right, so it's really fun, and it plays off of the idea of sort of taking flight. And for anyone that's ever watched any of our rocket launches of the past decade or so, has anyone seen videos of that? You may have noticed they don't always go according to plan. And they're often chaotic, there's lots of moving parts, and that's really what inspired this piece. And really at the end of the day, the other part of the inspiration, if that's one part, the other part was just wanting to come up with, I guess, a sequel to the other bassoon piece that I wrote, the other bassoon ensemble work. And these guys have been so wonderful over the years. They have performed my music and other people's music, and there's not too many people that I would call champions of contemporary composers, but I would definitely say that Rod Ackman and the Sooner Bassooners fall into that category. Can we go one more round of applause for how excellent these guys are? And the final thing I'll say about that piece is, in addition to the challenge it was for Rod and the fun that you heard for the whole ensemble, the entire piece is really just sort of one sort of interconnected texture, and Professor Ackman did mention one thing that it was a great way to get them to learn certain techniques in counting, and I really hope that they've all appreciated that, right? Yeah, it'll be really fun. Thank you so much again, Sooner Bassooners. Thank you all for coming out, and I hope you enjoy the rest of the concert.
While we're resetting, I'd like to take just a moment to recognize the very gifted arranger of that piece, longtime friend of mine from our years back in Tulsa, career educator from the Broken Arrow Public Schools, a fine instrumentalist, conductor, singer. He does it all, and this is Rob Reck. Rob, would you stand and receive our acknowledgement from the back? Not only did he craft that gorgeous setting that's so famous from the St. Olaf choir tradition, but he was here for our sound check and gave us an extra fresh set of ears, which I so needed, and put some finishing touches on that very piece. Thank you. You'll notice by looking over your program that there are actually several members of this group who either arranged our music or are serving as conductor. And such is the case with our next piece. So please join me in welcoming sophomore Bachelor of Music Education major Seth Roberts to conduct the Adagio in A flat by Chris Evan Harris.
Thank you.
I'd like to call the microphone now our wonderful graduate assistant in bassoon, Tyler Van Zuten, who will introduce the next piece, which he arranged.
Yeah, so this next piece is called Saima. So like much like we have here in Western orchestras, we have a rich tradition of orchestral music and chamber music, but they have had a lot of that sort of thing in China as well. So, and I was inspired by a chamber piece that was written with erhu, which is this, so it's like a cylindrical, like octagonal, like bass with a, you know, a bridge coming up from that. And instead of the hair strings of the bow being on the outside, they're actually on the inside of the string. And it's a very unique sound, and I tried to capture that in my arrangement of this Saima or racing horses piece. So I hope you'll enjoy.
Thank you.
While we're resetting here just a little bit, I'd like to acknowledge our arranger, Kylie Miller. Would you please stand, Kylie? That beautiful piece. It's always great when we can include our own as soloists in this concert, such as the case of our next piece. I'd like to have you join me in welcoming Ben Egan, who's a junior trumpet major from Norman, Oklahoma. He also serves as principal trumpet of our own OU Symphony Orchestra. And Ben is going to serve as trumpet soloist and trumpeter's lullaby. Please welcome Ben. Take just a couple more minutes here just to reconfigure our own bassoon quartet from within the Sooner Bassooners. This group is known as Bis Avena, Two Reeds. And this is a group that rehearses on their own during the week, then comes in for a weekly coaching session with me. And I'm just most pleased with their initiative that they take. They set their own goals, they stay organized day to day. And I've asked Seth once again to maybe say a few words about this piece.
Hello. Okay, this is the contraption. We are playing the third and fifth movements. This piece was originally composed for sax quartet by Lachlan Kuhn, and it's all about just the creation of this machine or contraption. And so there's five movements total, and so each movement kind of builds a new part, and then the fifth movement kind of puts everything together, and so you hear motifs from different movements all together in the fifth. So we are playing movement three, bellows, and movement five, activation.
Thank you. Thank you.
Well, as we head in the final few weeks of the semester, I think it's a good time to reflect on the many proud accomplishments of our bassoon studio here at OU. Tonight marks our sixth public performance of the year, in addition to several community outreach events with smaller units within the Sooner Bassooners. Our students have won significant competitions, including Jake Garcia winning first place in the Oklahoma City Ladies Music Club competition. Jake. Also earning runner-up honors in that same competition was Lisa Barrington. Seth Roberts took second place in the Midwest Double Reed Society Eric Varner Collegiate Solo Competition at Lawrence, Kansas. So a hearty congratulations to these outstanding bassoonists. Now I'd like to recognize two special bassooners who have made outstanding contributions during their years at OU. The first one, this is tough, weathered the many challenges of COVID. Vivid memories for us all. Taking her lessons under trees, under tents, sometimes with challenging weather and in the dark sometimes. We had standbys, right? With the wind, with the dust, with the allergies, with the cicadas, on and on. A tough cookie here. Not only is this person a terrific bassoonist, she's also a gifted pianist and singer. I'd like to recognize two of the recipients of the Sooner Bassooner of the Year Award. First, to Chloe Kelly. Chloe, would you come up? Chloe is finishing her student teaching in Tuttle, yes? Okay, so doing really well there. The other Sooner of the Bassoon Year Award goes to a very special student who has always led our studio with distinction, class, and abundance of maturity. He was finalist this year of the OU Concerto Competition and has already taken two professional orchestral auditions. And on top of all this activity, he's presenting his graduate recital this Friday. Please join me in recognizing Tyler Benzer. Before we play our last number, I want to thank all of you for coming out tonight, those tuned in via live stream, and welcome you to a nice little reception we're going to have in Gothic Hall. As soon as we pack up, we'll be out there and shaking hands, signing autographs, whatever. So thank you again for coming.